Hello everyone, Jerry Cherry Pie here, and today I have the Benelli M4 semi-automatic shotgun. The MSRP on this is $2,269. Let's see what you get for the money. So by now, everyone, you're probably well aware of the M4. If you're not, this is the fourth version. They have an M1, M2, M3. Those are all inertia-style semi-automatics. This is their first gas one in the lineup. So it has been used by the Marine Corps since about 1998. And the M4 was also featured in John Wick 2. And the M2 was featured in John Wick 3. So this semi-automatic gas operated, it is a self-regulating gas system, so it will reliably cycle light loads through heavy loads. You don't have to do any kind of tweaking. The gun will automatically correct itself, so it'll cycle reliably. It features an 18.5-inch barrel, which is perfect for close quarters combat. You know, the longer the barrel, the more accurate it will be, but it'll be hard if you're a Marine Corps, you know, if you're a Marine and you're trying to bust in a room looking for Osama bin Laden, trying to maneuver a huge ass shotgun is hard. So this gives you that pow pow pow. Where's the weapons of mass destruction? Pow. Anyways, this comes in a, you know, plain blue steel. This particular model is a titanium Cerakote. So the receiver, barrel, and magazine tube are Cerakoted with a titanium color. And some of the, bolt and some of the internal parts are Cerakote with a black color. And just the Cerakoting, their Cerakoting will help with corrosion and rust, so that the gun won't rust in wet, you know, humid conditions. So if you're a Marine and you're running around on deserts, storming deserts and all that, storming beaches, you don't have to worry about your gun corroding in the salt water. But it's also very good for home defense. You know, you don't have to worry about constantly bathing your gun and cleaning it all the time. It will stay pretty for a long time. It has a 5-capacity tube, and it accepts 3-inch shells. So, of course, if you have 3-inch shells, you might not get the whole 5 in there. There are aftermarket tubes you can buy to get extended shots, but it starts looking a little wonky having that many. It does have a rubberized pistol grip, synthetic stock, ghost rings, sights on the back. So there's a big old circle on the back, and the front is just your standard flat white paint and dot. So with the ghost ring in the back, you have that big wide open aperture so you can quickly acquire your target in close combat situations. You also get a 5-inch rail on top so that you can add your favorite red dots. And one of the advantages of having this gas operating system compared to the inertia recoil systems, the gas operating system will run reliably if you add more weight, such as red dots. Some of the other guns, like the M1s and M2s and other brands, the inertia style recoils, some automatic recoils, they'll be a lighter gun and you'll have less felt recoil, but they're very, very susceptible to weight. So if you start to add red dots on top or other accessories, the gun might not function properly. So that's a trade-off. Heavier gun, but it works fine with no matter what you add to it. It does have a nice little smooth, very thin, very small, but charging handle, so you can grab it easy, charge your gun, and just a push button safety. Push one side, you have a big triangle on this side for safe, the other side is just a circle, red is dead. They claim that it is ambidextrous sling mounted, so the gun is not ambidextrous. Obviously the charging handle is on this side, it's non-reversible, so if you're a lefty you won't be able to charge it, but you do have a sling point on this side of the stock and on that side and in the bottom middle here, so you can carry it like this. You just won't be able to operate it left-handed. So anyways, that's just the way they did it. If you're a left-handed shooter by now, you should know you've got to start practicing right-handed or you're going to have a long, expensive gun shooting career. And that's all there really is to say about the gun. Just a good quality gun. It works with just about any ammo you can think of. Very low felt recoil. And when you need to shoot 6 shotgun shells at somebody in rapid succession, and you need it to work every time, this is the one for you. So let me know below, guys. What do you think? Do you have an M4? Or do you stick to the cheaper Turkish-made Citadels and Bosses and Fears and stuff like that? Thanks for watching, everybody. Be sure to hit that thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.